Welcome back. So we are leaving Twin Bridges, Montana, and driving towards Dillon, 28 miles, which is where hopefully we will end this video, unless there's another town. Making a bunch of short videos potentially here. Try and clean the window. I'll wait till there's something really big in front of the camera. Yeah, I'll have to stop at a gas station and wash the windows again and buy a funnel. this road is not scenic at all like I thought it would be. The only reason I'm glad I went on it is I saw Virginia City and Nevada City and the gold mining garnet place. I would love to go back to those three areas. But other than that, there's nothing on it. Just a bunch of ranches and no mountains. Montana 41 now. When I was on Montana 287, they called it the Mountain Highway. I would say that's a stretch. Were to get home tonight, the only good thing about that is I would go through Tacoma, Seattle after rush hour. So it's tempting. It would be between 11 and 12 o'clock at night. Very tempting. There's a lot of truck traffic on this road. We're getting 28 miles a gallon so far. Actually showing a 678 mile range on this tank, which I haven't got that for a long time. That would be awesome. Miles to Dillon, Montana yet. Like I thought I would, we went around a mountain range to my left. You can't even see it. We're so far away from it. Well, and the haze from the smoke. Once we start going west again, I will try and clean the windows, unless I stop at a gas station in Dillon. basically we're going southwest now. And then we'll go southwest in a bit. These trucks are going. Oh, I wonder if this is a shortcut from I-15 to I-90 going east. Probably is. Like, kind of cut across instead of going up and over. Slower than me, and I'm going 60 in a 70. A lot of people think I go slow, but if you're going more than 10 miles an hour under the speed limit, you're going really slow. Some people think I'm going really slow, but not by my criteria. Dillon is at 14 miles. So that last town, I think it was Twin Bridges. I'll have to double check. Wow, there's a wildlife refuge on the right. I don't mind getting home potentially today is I'll be close enough to home that, you know, any place that I would want to stop or see, I could drive to it a day or less from, you know, our house. All right, I need to pass this car. I don't know why they're going so slow. Wow, there's a giant something over there. Oh, it's a motel. I wonder if it's for hunters, because there's nothing around here. Wow, really neat. Had tons of windows, a whole wraparound deck. It was giant. Alright, let's pass this guy soon. It's not very often I get behind someone going slower than me. This is like maybe the second time the entire trip, you know. You know, 1,500 miles. hit something big. Not sure where it hit. Must have hit right above the glass, because I don't see it on the windshield, but it sure made a noise. Slowing down because there's a UPS truck smoking up ahead. It's like, just turn your air recirculate on, buddy. Man, all this flat road and I get behind this guy when it is not flat all of a sudden, and there's no passing hardly. Oh, it's amazing how much hay they grow out west. I guess it's no different than growing corn or something else that they feed to cows or chickens, except this is grass. It's easier though. Just add water, I guess. I don't know why the road is not in the valley. Probably because there's ranches. We're going up over these hills. It's flat, literally like a block to my right. Perfectly flat. Over at Dillon, because I gotta figure out where I'm going. I got one more mountain area to cut across. Hopefully it's better than this. Now the guy speeds up when there's a passing zone. I really hate people like that. I don't understand them. Do they realize? Do they know what they're doing? Get over, buddy, unless you want to fucking run into a semi. What a fucking dumb shit. That's BMW smarts right there. When you make that kind of money, your time is precious, I guess. More important than dying. What an idiot. There he goes again. Of course, he doesn't have a semi coming this time. See it all on this channel. Proof of the stupidity. the least amount of smoke I saw was in the Wasatch Mountains, Park City area, and Yellowstone. Other than that, there's been smoke everywhere. Oh, Snoqualmie Pass had no smoke, so that was good. Blocking the road. Jeez, it's giant. That sucks. I don't know why this car didn't go around. He had time. I think that's an old, big harvester. Tractor. That is a real nice tractor. I could have passed this guy, but we're almost in town. I'm not in that much of a hurry anymore. Miles to go. Sandwich here, I think. Oh, there's a Novus auto glass there. Seen a golf course that busy in a while. Parking lot was full, had a lot of trucks and stuff. This is Dillon, Montana. We're gonna find a place to pull over, hopefully a gas station, where we can buy a funnel also. And eat our lunch, our sandwich. There's an Exxon up ahead. Probably try that. But this light is long, I will stop this video, maybe. Oh, I need to watch the window, too. Come on, buddy, it's green. This person is a little challenged, maybe. Very slow driver. Home of the Beavers. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna stop. I don't know if I am gonna stop there. It looks really busy. Thought about stopping at the McDonald's parking lot. There's a little park memorial thing. Oh, I missed the. Oh, there's a giant Safeway. Wow, they're packed. We'll find a place. It's gonna pull over in this laundromat parking lot.
Quarter of a mile, turn left. In 500 feet, turn left to East Helena Street.
Wow, this is
turn left to East Helena Street.
It's downtown Dillon, it looks like. It's pretty big.
In 400 feet, turn left to East Banach Street.
Yeah, it's actually really big.
Turn left to East Banach Street. Route guidance is now
finished. I had to turn her off. Yeah, there's tons of stuff here. This is a really old town, it looks like. So now, we're gonna go, oh, look at this old train depot. I'm gonna park right here. Oh, the old Depot Theater. But thanks for watching Twin Bridges to Dillon, Montana.